بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا. من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له. أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. أما بعد، السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Viewers and listeners through the media, this is the second class on the book of Uthman ibn Fodi, Hidayatul Tullabi ila Tariqa Shawab. If you have not forgotten, last week we have gone into the book and we started the book, and the first lesson in the book, he said he's going to put 10 things in the book, and we started with the first one. The first one being that أن جميع ما جاء عن الشرع عليه الصلاة والسلام لا يسمى مذهبا لأحد بل هو شريعة يجب العمل بها على كل متدين بالإسلام ويجب إجابة دعوة كل من دعا إليه. That whatever comes from the Prophet is not called the madhab of anybody, but we call it the Sharia, and it's compulsory upon anyone following the religion of Islam to follow it. And what to accept the call of anyone who calls yani towards it. If you have not forgotten, I was reading from yani the sayings of the four common madhab. That's the words that they are saying, that whenever they say something in contrary to the Quran and the Sunnah, that what should be taken is what? The Quran and the Sunnah. And last week we talked about that of Abu Hanifa and Al-Imam Malik rahimahumullahu, because it's no one rahimahumullah. Now today we'll come to Al-Imam Shafi'i rahimahullah. And I'm reading from the book, just like I said last week, صفة الصلاة النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم من التكبير إلى التسليم كأنك تراها. And today we read the same of Al-Imam Al-Shafi'i. إذا وجدتم في كتابي خلاف سنة رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم فقولوا بسنة رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. الله أكبر. ودعوا ما قلت. Is that إذا وجدتم في كتابي, if you find it in my book, خلاف سنة رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم, that which is in contrary to the words of the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, فقولوا بسنة رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. See, be upon that which transmits that which the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said as that which is correct. ودعوا ما قلت, and leave that which I said. وفي رواية أن رواية فاتبعوها ولا تلتفتوا إلى قول أحد. He said, leave it, leave my saying, and do not take what the words of any other person, whoever it is. The words of the Prophet ﷺ, when it comes, you must leave it. If you check the book of Imam Al-Harawi, in his book Dhamm Al-Kalam, عن خديب البغدادي أن نسبك الاحتجاج بالشافعي. نعم. In another رواية from him, another author from الإمام الشافعي, he said إذا صح الحديث هو مذهبي. Whenever a hadith is authentic, know that that is my madhab. That means even if you see my words is contradicting a hadith, and that hadith is authentic, with the what condition the hadith is what? Authentic. Then know that it's my madhab. Why I did not bring it is because I did not know it. That's what he's trying to say. Whenever it is authentic, just know that that is my what? That is my madhab. Therefore, those who are being taqlid with these scholars, trying to hold even when they have hadith regarding it, that means they are not following what? The guidance of these scholars. May Allah Azza wa Jalla guide us. Al-Imam Al-Hakim and Imam Al-Bayhaqi all narrated it. The next one is what? Al-Imam Ahl Sunnah wal Jama'ah, Ahmad ibn Hanbal, rahimahullah. Al-Imam Ahmad bin Hanbal is reported to have said, لا يقلدني ولا يقلد مالكا ولا شافعي ولا الأوزاعي ولا الثوري وخذ من حيث أخذ. الإمام أحمد is reported to have said, do not do taqleed. The meaning of taqleed is what? blindly follow him. Do not follow me blindly. And do not blindly follow Al-Imam Malik. And do not blindly follow Al-Imam Shafi. And do not blindly follow Al-Imam Al-Awza'i. And do not blindly follow Al-Imam Sufyan al-Thawri. He say, وَخُذْ مِنْ حَيْثُ أَخُذُ. Take from where they take. Those opinions of theirs are based on the Quran and the Sunnah. So also take from where they have taken it. Take from the Quran and the Sunnah and the words are explanation of the pious predecessors. In another riwayah, but this riwayah first is narrated by Al-Falabi, Al-Falani, and Ibn Qayyim al-Jawziyya in his book Al-Ilam al-Muwaqi'in. Ibn Qayyim al-Jawziyya, he brought this narration also in his book. وَفِي رُوَيَةٍ another riwayah, another narration, لَا يُقَلِّدَ دِينَكَ أَحَدًا مِنْ هَؤُلَى. Do not blindly, put your religion based on the blind followership of what anybody among these people. Among these people, that means Al-Imam Malik, Shafi'i, Al-Imam Al-Awza'i, or Sufyan al-Thawri. Do not put your base your religion on blindly following what one of these scholars. Ma ja'a an Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam wa ashabahu fakhudh bihi. Whatever comes from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the Sahaba, hold on to it. Thumma tabi'ina ba'da ar-rajul fihi mukhair. And then the tabi'in, those who follow the companion of Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, after what these are any companions, what comes from the word the tabi'in, follow on to it. That is what, that which is what better for you. وَقَالَ مَرَّةٌ, he said severally, أَلِتِّبَاءُ أَنْ يَتَّبِعَ الرَّجُلُ ما جاء عن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم وعن أصحابه ثم هو من بعد التابعين مخير هو مخير أو المخير هو so the scholars of Nahu they will understand this better. الاتباع, the followership that we have been commanded with, أن يتبع, that a man should follow what? مَا جَاءَ عَنِ النَّبِيِّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ, that which comes from the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم, وَعَنْ أَصْحَابِهِ, and that which comes from his companions, ثُمَّ هُوَ مِنْ بَعْدِ التَّابِعِينَ, and then after them are what? The tabi'in. The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم in the hadith narrated by Imam al-Bukhari, he said, خَيْرُ الْقُرُونَ قُرْنِي ثُمَّ الَّذِينَ يَلُونَهُمْ ثُمَّ الَّذِينَ يَلُونَهُمْ. The best of my nation, the best of what? My nation is what? My generation, then those who follow them, the tabi'in, and then those who follow them. And he said, and then the tabi'in, that is what is better for a person. Al-Imam Abu Dawud narrated it in his book, Masail al-Imam Ahmad, in page number 276 and page number 277. Now, so let's come back into the, onto our book that we are treating of Uthman Ibn Fodi, rahimahullah. He said, "Thani ha," the second thing that I brought in this book, "Anna Allah Taala lam yujib ala ahadin fi kitabihi wala rasulihi fi sunnatihi iltizama madhhabi min madhahib al-mujtahidin bikhususihi wa lam yablughna ahadan min ulama'i as-salaf amara ahadan an yuqallida bi madhhabin mu'ayyinin walaw waqa'a dhalika la'uqa'u fil ithmi." Allahu Akbar. لتفويتهم والعمل على عمل بكل حديث لم يأخذ به ذلك المجتهد الذي أمر الخلق باتباعه وحده. He said the second is أن الله the verily surely Allah Azza wa Jal has not لم يوجب. Allah Azza wa Jal has not made a compulsory على أحد upon anybody في كتابه in his book ولا رسوله or his prophet في سنته in his sunnah التزام مذهب من مذاهب المجتهدين بخصوصه, that we must follow the madhab of a one particular scholar, one particular mujtahid. That is, you see, the error of the words they are telling, that we Africa It is Malikiyah that is for us. Another part of the world is Shafi'iyah. There is Hanabila and the like, Hanbaliyah. So the teaching of Islam, there is no way that Allah has made it compulsory upon us to follow one specific word madhab of any mujtahid. So when they say, when you bring something and then you are saying that this is from Prophet, and they say, but this is not the madhab that we are following here in Africa, it is rubbish and misguidance. And this could even what take someone what out of Islam. See, when they say the Prophet ﷺ has said this, and you say, but so so and so scholar has said this, that statement alone is an act of kufr. That statement is an what? Act of kufr. وَلَمْ يَبْرُقْنَا أَحَدًا مِنْ عُلَمَاءِ السَّلَمِ. And it has not, we haven't received any narration from the scholars of the prior predecessors. أَمَرَ أَحَدًا أَنْ يُقَلِّدَ بِمَذْهَبٍ مُعَيِّنٍ. That what be commanded anybody to hold on to the madhab of anybody. Look at the companions of Prophet ﷺ. Fitna occurred between them that they what even killed one another. But let me, they fought one another. They had to go into one. But yet they will come and tell one of them that we have seen so so and so did this. And they are on the opposite side. He will say he is in accordance with the Sunnah. Read Sahih al-Bukhari. For Imam al-Bukhari, they will come and meet Abdullah ibn Abbas. They will say what? Yani Muawiyah radiallahu anhu, that when it was the day of Eid, he just came and what prayed Eid. He did not come out for Jum'ah. He said what? He is in accordance what with the Sunnah. He said he is in accordance with the Sunnah. May Allah Azza wa Jalla guide us. He said, "Wala waqa'a dhalika la awqa'u fil ithmi." He said, if they had commanded that, then know that what? They will have fallen into sin. لِتَفْوِيتِهُمُ الْعَمَلُ بِكُلِّ حَدِيثٍ لَمْ يَأْخُذْ بِهِ ذَلِكَ الْمُجْتَهِدِ الَّذِي أَمَرَ الْخَلْقَ بِاتِّبَاعِهِ وَحْدًا. Because that it is not possible that what? Every hadith that particular scholar that they say they should follow his madhab, that mujtahid, it is not every hadith that he has worked with. It is not every hadith that he knows. This is one of the reasons that caused differentiation of scholars. Check the book of Sheikh al-Islam, Raf al-Malami, An al-A'immat al-A'lam. So that means what? When another scholar now receives a hadith that the other one does not have, that means we will not take the hadith, because what? He have commanded us to follow what? A particular madhab of a particular mujtahid. And they had never done that. He said if they had done that, they would have even fall into sin. May Allah Azza wa Jalla guide us. And Malan used a word here. He said as-salaf. Min ulama is salaf, from the scholars of the salaf. What is the origin of this word as-salaf? Check the book what man is salafiyuna wa limadha yakhafuna salafiyya of Abdul Aziz Al-Utaybi. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam narrated by Imam Muslim, Imam Bukhari, Imam Muslim, Imam Abu Dawud, wa Tirmidhi, wa Nasa'i, wa Ibn Majah. They all narrated from the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam while he was passing away. He called Nana Fatima and he told her two things. The first made her cry and the second made her smile. The wife of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said she should please tell her what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said. I can't tell you his secret because he kept me aside and told me. After the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam passed away, they asked her that what the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam tell you. She said amma al-ana fa na'am. Now that the Prophet is not alive, it is a knowledge which I have to share. He said, the first time he said to me that he will not recover from what? From his illness. So she cried. The second time he said, I'll be the first among the family to join him. And then he added by saying, Fattakillaha. Fear Allah. Fa inni ni'ma salafu analahi. For what a great, what a blessed salaf, a blessed predecessor am I to you. So the word as-salaf, a pious predecessor. But you today, you can't call yourself what this a salaf. You can't call yourself, you can't.